macOS Tahoe 26.2 update finally released, but should you upgrade or skip Tahoe? First, let's take a look at what's new in this update. In macOS 26.2, FaceTime now includes an edge light feature that acts as a virtual light to enhance lighting during video calls. This feature can be accessed from the menu bar. Click the FaceTime icon and select Edge Light. Reminders now support alarms. You can now mark a reminder as urgent and get an alarm when it's due on your iPhone or iPad. The Freeform app now supports tables. You can arrange text, shapes, photos, and more in rows and columns. The Apple Arcade section of the App Store lets you sort the list of arcade games by release date, last updated, name, and category. You can also apply additional filters such as game controller, multiplayer options, and age ratings. There is a feature you might not know about that was added in macOS Tahoe 26.1, so I wanted to highlight it in case you are interested. You can now adjust the spotlight clipboard history limit from 8 hours to 30 minutes for better privacy, or to 7 days to improve productivity. In this update, Apple also delivers security enhancements along with bug fixes. Before updating or upgrading, backup your Mac or clone your internal drive to an external one to avoid potential data loss. To update, click System Settings in the dock, then select General, followed by Software Update. macOS Tahoe 26.2 was released on December 12, 2025. It's about 11.22 GB on my MacBook Pro M4. I will install it over version 26.2 beta. The update size may vary depending on your current macOS version. When you are ready to proceed, click Update Now. Click Agree. Enter your admin password and press OK to complete the installation. The installation is in progress and will take some time. I'll pause recording to save your time and resume once it's finished. I'll also inform you if any issues come up during the process. The macOS Tahoe update installation is now complete. It took about 25 minutes on the MacBook Pro M4, but the time may vary depending on your Mac and internet connection. The Apple logo and a progress bar appeared 4 times during the installation, including 3 black screens lasting approximately 5, 5, and 4 seconds. I didn't face any issues during installation and can now run macOS Tahoe 26.2 on my MacBook Pro M4. Should you upgrade or skip macOS Tahoe 26.2? If your Mac is essential for work or important projects, it's advisable to wait until the next update. This allows Apple to resolve initial bugs and developers to update their apps for complete compatibility. If you don't rely on your Mac for work, are okay with occasional glitches, and want to explore the new features, it's safe to upgrade now. A more secure method is to install macOS Tahoe on a separate volume. If your Mac has sufficient space, this enables you to try out the new system without risking your main setup, and you can easily remove the unnecessary volume later. Here is a step-by-step tutorial on creating a separate volume. You can access the link in the description box below or watch it at the end of this video. If you're looking for free Mac apps to boost security and optimize your Mac's performance, access the link in the description box by clicking on More below this video. Open the link in your browser and find the list of all free app tutorials on the right. What has been your experience with macOS Tahoe so far? And if you haven't upgraded, which option best describes you? Waiting for stability or not interested yet? Which Mac are you using right now? Intel or Apple Silicon? Please leave your comment in the comments section. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on my profile picture and sharing the video links with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.